You see, dear ones, you will only see that which has always been when you stop looking for that which will be. You can only see what is here and now when you stop thinking about your past and thinking about your future. You can only see that which is beyond the mind when you stop giving power to your thoughts and mental desires. And so, dear ones, accept that you are love, and therefore there is nothing you need to do to create this love. You simply need to stop and realize it, and see that which has always been. We understand, dear ones, that many of you suffer, that many of you experience deep separation, deep loss, and deep sadness. Understand that the solution to your suffering will not come by pursuing new ideas. It will not come from buying new self-help courses. It will not come from accumulating more material wealth. Happiness, dear ones, true happiness, eternal happiness, will only come from transcending your mind, from stepping out of the chaos and confusion and the suffering that your mind is creating. You see, dear ones, as long as you live within the box of your mind, you are living in the prison of your ego. You are trapped. You are contained. You are not feeling and knowing the freedom that is you. You are not feeling the peace. You are not feeling the oneness. It is the ego, dear ones. It is our sense of a personal self. It is our belief of being a personality. It is all of our thoughts about who we are. It is all of our judgments about who we are. It is our thoughts and judgments of who the world is, what other people are. It is our opinions, our likes and dislikes. It is all of these beliefs that create separation, that create duality. And as long as we choose to live through these beliefs, then, dear ones, we are experiencing separation within. And then we are suffering. For our heart knows the oneness of all of life. Our true self experiences this oneness. It is this oneness. Yet it is this ego that has imprisoned us, that has created the illusion of being cut off from life around us. And it is this ego that is causing the superficial construct of our own personal suffering. And so, dear ones, like a caged animal, you can choose to fight against the walls. You can lash out. You can be violent. You can attack your mind, attack this prison, attack yourself. And you will not be free. Within this prison of the ego, you can choose to sit and study. You can choose to learn about these walls, about these bars surrounding you. You can create sciences of psychology and understand these bars, what they are made of, how they were built. But this will never take you out of this cage. These practices may change the color, the decorations of your cage. They may change how you live within your cage. They may make it feel more like home. They may make it more comfortable, but as long as you live within the cage of your personal ego, you are still a prisoner. And so, dear ones, strive not to make a clean and tidy cage, but strive instead to be free from the cage altogether. The truth, dear ones, is you are love. Everything is love. And why would that which you are, why would the source of all life deny you this love? Why would it hide from you that which you are? The truth, dear ones, is that you are hiding yourself. You are denying yourself. And it is your fear. It is your fear that is keeping you from stepping out of this cage. That, dear ones, is all. being motivated by the deeper fear of that which we are, being motivated by the deeper fear of letting ourselves die to our personal identity, being motivated by this fear, we choose to distract ourselves in any way possible while we stay sitting inside this cage of the ego. We choose to fill our mind with new knowledge and create superior beliefs about ourselves while we walk in circles around this cage, dictating to our own being how great we are, shouting out to tell others how great we are. All the while we are speaking to projections of our own mind. Like a madman within this cage, we are telling others who we are, who we should be, how they should see us. And yet we are still within the cage, and we are still avoiding the truth. We are still letting our fear decide how we create our experience. And so, dear ones, how do we free ourselves from this cage? It is quite simple. You must have the strength to be yourself, to stay in awareness, and to stay in the state of surrender, and allow anything at all to arise within your meditation. You must choose to simply sit and stay in awareness. You must not judge that which you see, but you must understand that every experience is temporary, and as long as you stay in the state of loving surrender, of loving allowance, you will continue to see more deeply within yourself. You will continue to purify these layers of your ego until nothing else remains except that which is truth. You, dear ones, will sit and surrender, knowing exactly what you are doing, yet not thinking a thought. You know, dear ones, that you have within yourself the deep, silent desire for truth, the desire to know God, the desire to be free from suffering altogether. And you know that this is far greater than the chatter in your mind, than the talk in your head. So let this silent desire be your guide. You need not think about it. Instead, you simply need allow it. Allow it to carry you as you sit in silent surrender, letting it all go and trusting in that which you are. Trusting that the truth will be given to you, for as your heart is sincere to know God, God will not hold itself from you. Instead, God will help you dissolve the walls that you have created.